Let's talk about how this little girl was born. It was a clear dark night, a clear dark moon. Mr. Warren G was trying to consume regulators!
Like a bomb.
You're getting heavy now.
I've been praying so hard. She's been having contractions.
Here we go.
This is crazy.
Yeah, she's about to be here.
Something about you.
Your
every move. It's like the sun comes up, yeah, just to shine on you. You're a wildflower in a world of weeds.
Hey guys, what's up? My name's Cullen. This is my wife, Katie. We have a little girl. Her name's Macy Gaines. She goes by Gaines, though, but Macy Gaines when she's in trouble.
She's in trouble when she's cute too.
And we're gonna tell you about her birth story.
Yay, finally. She is currently 3 weeks, 3.5 weeks old, and we're finally just getting around to doing this. So I hope I remember all the details. There may be a lot of details just because I want to remember everything for myself too. I told Cullen he's just gonna have to get over it and let me share all the details I want.
I'm gonna get some popcorn. Let's do this. It all started one night, me and your mom, we were eating some M&Ms and she ate the blue ones. You know what happens when you eat the blue M&Ms? Babies!
What? You're so funny. She doesn't look very comfortable.
Okay, go.
Okay, hang on. Let's get her head right.
It's fine. Let's go.
There. Okay. All right, so I'm not going to go back too far, but I will just give a little tidbit of Thursday. She was born on Sunday. So Thursday, we had been going for twice a week, NSTs, which is a non-stress test, just to check on her, check on my blood pressure. I was having high blood pressure. Not severely high, but just enough that they wanted me to be resting, modified bed rest. So we had gone in on Thursday. Everything looked good. They checked fluid. They checked the monitored contractions, monitored her movement and everything. Everybody looked good.
Pause it right here and go back and watch those videos if you have any questions.
Yes.
They're all in our daily vlogs. And we have a playlist to this little journey to baby. Baby.
Yes, so all the pregnancy history and all that, you can go watch that in the Journey to Baby, how we got here, and you can put the vlogs from that Thursday, Friday, Saturday, and Sunday in the description below as well.
They're below.
If you want to see more details about those days. So Thursday was good. Fast forward to Friday, we had told this little princess she was going to need to wait until our iPhone 6s came in because we needed to have room on our phones to take pictures. We had the iPhone 4 and we had no room to take pictures. So we were like, we have to have those first. So on Friday, we were at home, of course, because I was on bed rest, so I wasn't working. And we were at home. Our iPhone 6s came. We were very excited. We unboxed them and made a video about all that and got those set up. That was pretty cool. So we were like, okay, they're here now. She can come, jokingly. Her due date was October 10th, and she was born on September 21st. So she was a little bit 3 weeks early. So then
she was full term though.
Yes, full term. She was 37 weeks and 2 days when she was born. So that is technically considered full term. She's got one eye open and it's rolled back in her head. Do you want to put her in her crib?
Yeah.
We'll put her in her crib for the rest of the story. Okay, so we got our iPhones. We were ready. And then Friday night, we got packed up and went to Tuscaloosa because there was a football game. We go down to the home games in Tuscaloosa for the University of Alabama football.
Road high.
And Alabama was playing Florida, so we went down Friday night. We had all of our hospital bags packed already.
Were you having contractions by this point?
No. No, well, I'd had some during the week, like just random contractions, and I'd even mentioned them to my doctor when we saw him on Thursday, and he was like, but you're still pregnant, right? And I was like, yes, so obviously they didn't do anything.
AKA Braxton Hicks, maybe?
Yeah, well, I don't know. I mean, Braxton Hicks supposedly don't hurt, and these were painful ones that I had actually, like, recorded.
It was just gas.
From what I'd read online, if they stop when you like get up and start walking and moving around, then they're not real contractions. And these did stop when I got up and start moving around, like the week before. And the doctor at that appointment on Thursday had actually said, I asked him if he was gonna check me and see if I was dilated at all. And he was like, well, since you have a C-section scheduled, I'm not gonna do that unless you just want me to. And I was like, no, that's okay, I'm good. So he didn't check me. So I don't know. I know the week before when the nurse had checked me, I was zero centimeters, like nothing at all. Had our hospital bags in the car. We'd had them in the car for a week or so because we knew that my high blood pressure, we could go at any time. Because we had to pack stuff to take to Tuscaloosa, we took a couple things out.
We took out the pillows that were supposedly supposed to help in the hospital, which they did because we got them later. And we took out the cord blood banking, the cord blood banking thing.
Because we knew my car was going to be parked in Tuscaloosa like for the whole weekend. Usually at our house, it stays in the garage. So it wasn't that big of a deal. It was staying like temperature regulated, but we didn't want it to get overheated.
Too hot, yeah, sitting in the sun.
So we took that out. The car seat was already installed. All that stuff was good. So Friday night in Tuscaloosa, we just chilled. My parents were there. We hung out with them. I think we got down there pretty late Friday night. And then
yeah, because we had to go get our iPhone cases.
Oh, yeah, we went and got our iPhone cases. We just took our time. Got to Tuscaloosa. It was probably like 9 or 10. 10 when we got down there. Yeah. So Saturday morning, the September 20th, we woke up, Cullen got ready to go to Alabama, was playing Florida, and the game was at 2:30. We slept in a little bit, got up, I started writing thank you notes from the baby shower. Cullen was getting ready. My mom had hurt her back, so her back was not doing well, so she and I were going to stay in the at the condo. My parents have a condo that we stay in Tuscaloosa. We were going to stay there and not walk to the game and stress ourselves out with my high blood pressure and her back. So
boys day.
Boys day at the game.
Yeah, roll tide.
You left about noon to go to the tailgate.
Yep.
Right?
And I FaceTimed her just to keep everybody in the loop and show her the tailgate and all the fun that was being had without her.
I know. I was very sad not to go. It was the first time we've ever like separately, you've gone to the game and I haven't. We usually go together.
That's what put her in labor.
It really was. He stressed me out being gone to the game. That's a story that we'll get to later. So Cullen went to the tailgate. We FaceTimed a little bit. We had my aunt and uncle came down. They came and saw us at the in the condo. Heather, our friend Heather, came to the condo. And I saw some people, so we were hanging out. And then at 2:30, the game started. My mom and I were watching the game. We actually have footage in the daily vlog of kickoff and everything else.
That put me into labor, was the game.
The game was
stressful. It was like, what's going on? This team is killing us.
But I was pretty tired at this point, like being, you know, towards the end of pregnancy, you're more tired and that kind of stuff. So I was just kind of like, whatever, I'm pregnant, I'm gonna watch this game, but right now it's not the most important thing on my list. Oh, excuse you. We watched the game. I was laid out on the sofa. Like, I wasn't stressing about the game. My mom was on one sofa. I was on the other one. We were just chilling. So I actually fell asleep during halftime and missed, like, most of the third quarter.
It's your fault.
I know. So the third quarter was actually really stressful. Everybody was like, oh, that game will put you into labor. I slept through most of it. Woke up for the fourth quarter. Woke up for the fourth quarter. Watched most of that. Game was over. I think at that point I was still feeling fine. It takes a while to get back to the condo after the game was over. So my dad came back, my aunt and uncle came back. We were all just hanging out. And I think at that point I might have had like a few contractions, but they didn't feel like, I mean, they were just kind of the Braxton Hicks stuff.
Yeah.
You know, it was like tightening and I didn't think anything, honestly, like anything of it at all. She's like, okay, well, it's cool. I've just been laying in the same position for a while. I need to get up and move around. Cullen calls and says he's leaving the game and he should be back shortly. He's walking one of our friends to meet their, walking our friend Bees to meet some of his friends.
We went back to the tailgate.
They went back to the tailgate. I said, you're not staying at the tailgate, are you? Because we were planning on going back home Saturday night.
I didn't stay at the tailgate that long.
You told me you were leaving the tailgate and then an hour later, oh, I just left the tailgate.
Well, anyway, once you get back, you know, you get into like a time zone warp where it's just like, where did the time go?
And so my family that had been at the game too was back in the condo. And so I was like, okay, Colin's just walking somebody back.
And then I ran into some viewers.
Yeah, well, I'm not to that yet. I'm not to that. So at this point, he says he's leaving the tailgate. He's just figured everything out.
Hey, this isn't about me. This is about our child and the birth story.
This is going to be about the birth story. And then I said, ooh, you're going to pass TCBY. Will you give me some yogurt?
Who got you yogurt?
So by this point, it's like 8 o'clock, and I haven't had dinner yet. And so I was like, what are we going to have for dinner? And he was like, well, I don't know. We'll figure something out when I get back. So I said, well, stop and get me some yogurt. And he was like, oh, and I was like, no, the line's going to be long. Just don't worry about it.
I got it for you.
So then all of a sudden, I get a text, hey, I'm at the yogurt place. What do you want? And I was like, oh, okay, he's going to get me yogurt. So then like 45 minutes have gone by, and he should have been home like 30 ago. So I call or text him, and I was like, what is going on? Where's my yogurt? And he was like, oh, I'm sitting here talking to some people. I'm like, with my melting yogurt? He's like, oh, I haven't gotten it yet.
I was walking in, and they stopped
me. Oh, my gosh. So by this point, it's been like 5 hours after the game, and I don't think I was really having contractions at this point. So I was stressing out, though, over him, and I was just like, would you just get back? I have not eaten anything, and I'm going to scream.
If you need anybody to put you in labor, just give me a call. My number is numbers, area code 807-664-2758.
Don't call that number. There's no telling who that calls. So then he goes in, gets the yogurt. So I know he has the yogurt, and I know the yogurt place is like 10 minutes walking distance.
Then I went to Jimmy John's.
And then all of a sudden it had been 30 minutes, and I was like, where is he? Why is it taking so long? I don't know what was going on in between him getting back to the condo.
I vlogged the whole thing.
The entire thing?
Pretty much.
It was not a 2-hour vlog.
Yeah, it wasn't that long.
Anyways, so Cullen was taking forever. He stopped and got Jimmy John's, which I wasn't eating that, so I was like, whatever, I'm just gonna eat yogurt for dinner.
Once again, if you want me to put you in labor, go to www.putmeinlabor.com. Hey, that'd be a good occupation. Like,
stress people out.
Have people, yeah. You need help, I will bring you hot sauce and chili and we'll do jumping jacks. I'll put your wife in labor.
Jeez.
That's a good.
But so at this point, I think you're crazy. I was having some contractions and they were fairly regular, but by regular I mean like 10 minutes apart or something, and it wasn't, it was like the ones I'd had the previous week. So I was like, well, the doctor said these weren't real and it's not a big deal. So I wasn't really worried about it. I was still laying on the couch and like adjusting my position and stuff. So calling up back with Jimmy John's, he brought, I think, my mom some Jimmy John's. It was by this time like 9 o'clock. The game had been over at 6:30.
Traffic's horrible.
You were walking.
There's a lot of people on the street.
It is a 15 minute walk or less, 10 to 15 from the stadium to the condo. So Cullen has not yet eaten his Jimmy John's, sits down on the couch. I'm all ticked off at him. He's ticked off at me, so we're not really speaking to each other.
I was like, I got your food and got your yogurt.
Which was like half melted by the time he got back with it. But I ate it anyway because I was starving because it was 9 o'clock and I hadn't had dinner. So Cullen sits on the couch next to my dad. There's still a million good football games on.
Oh, yeah.
Cullen passes out and is like snoring on the couch. And I'm sitting over there going, I think I'm having contractions kind of a little bit. This is interesting. So by, I really think it was like 10 o'clock when I kind of started taking them seriously.
I was still going, yo, go to the bathroom. I got some gas.
We were not speaking.
Well, in my head.
I mean, we were speaking. We weren't like really that mad at each other. It was just one of those like, ugh, you're driving me crazy. We really weren't like really that mad at each other. Okay. So I didn't actually start timing them until 10:57 that night. So we had sat there, Cullen had passed out on the couch. We were talking to my parents and all that. And this whole time it was like, I was feeling pain in my lower, like my pelvis area and in my back. And I just remember laying on the couch and I would rub my back when it would start hurting just to make it feel better. Like it was that enough pain that I felt like it helped just to rub it.
But when I tried to do it,
that was when I was at 10 centimeters.
Okay. So there's like, a difference. Well, dang.
Like if I'd have been in normal labor, if you had been with me at normal labor, then rubbing my back would have helped. But so I was rubbing my back and I was like, okay, I should probably start timing these. So I remember my dad got up to go to bed and so got up off the couch to go get in bed. And so I was like, okay, maybe I'll start timing these. So I started timing them at 10:57. At that point, I probably should have been more attentive to this. Look how close together
Dang.
They were.
10:57, 11:01, 11:07, 11:13, 11:21.
They were like 4 minutes, then 5 minutes.
And you waited another 2 hours?
No, it was 4 minutes, 5.5 minutes, 7 minutes, 8 minutes, 5 minutes, 3 minutes, 9 minutes, 6 minutes. So they were just very irregular. And then there's one at 11:54 that was 9 minutes apart. And so I was like, I just don't think these are real contractions. I think it's these same ones. But then around midnight, they started getting 3.5 minutes apart, 4.5 minutes, 6.5, 4.5, 3, 6. Then there was one, then it was like 14 minutes. So at this point I'm like, okay, seriously, this can't be real labor. And they were lasting like 2.5 to 3 minutes each contraction. And they said if your contractions are lasting a minute to call them, but
at this point she was starting to get into that crazy demon voice, like, oh,
no, that was not, that wasn't doing it in the car.
Well,
at this point, I was trying to be quiet because everybody was sleeping.
You were breathing hard, you're like,
yes, that probably was. No, this was the point at which I came in to you pass out on the couch and I was like, are you going to eat and go to bed? And you said, you just want me to wake up so I'll go come to bed with you. I was like, well, yeah. And so I went and laid down because I thought other times when I've been having contractions, if I just like try to relax and lay down, it's going to be okay. So I went and laid down in the bed and that made it worse. So I was like, dang it. And so Cullen was out there eating. And so I came out there and he was like, "You're just standing here because you want me to go to bed." I was like, "No, I'm standing here because I'm leaning over the couch because that's the only thing that makes my contractions better." And he was like, "You just need to go to the bathroom."
www.putmeintolabor.com.
Yes. So, I mean, at this point, they were hurting bad enough. I was leaning over the couch to like make it feel better. But I still really didn't think it was real labor. I guess I'm also one of those people, part of the reason I didn't take it seriously too was because I was like, we're in Tuscaloosa, we've got all our bags, we have our dogs, my parents are asleep. So if we'd have been here at home, we probably would have gone to the hospital sooner. But at that point I was like, we have to pack all of our stuff, I have to wake my parents up, like the dogs are here, what are we going to do about that? So I was just trying to hope it wasn't for real. I mean, I didn't really care.
In retrospect, it was probably one of the best scenarios because the dogs were with us. And so we were able to just leave them with your parents at the condo. But we'll get to all that.
Yes. And then they started getting consistently 4.5 minutes apart. And so at that point, I'm like, I'm going to call the hospital. I'm going to call the doctor and just see what they say. And the lady on the phone was like, "Ma'am, anybody that sounds like you do is usually in labor. So why don't you go ahead and come in?"
I'm having contractions. My husband won't talk to me.
Well, and I was like, I was like, hang on just a second. And it's been. And I remember I walked outside. No, I didn't have gas. I did not have gas. But there was something that they had told us in our birthing class, because everybody worries about like pooping on the delivery table.
Yeah.
And they had told us, they were like, actually, a lot of times people don't, because when you start going into labor, you usually gotta go. Like, you gotta
go. Your body naturally breaks everything down.
And so it comes on out. And so then at one point I was like, dang, now I just went to the bathroom and that's what they told me would happen if I was really in labor. Yeah. So
that, I told you it was gas.
They didn't stop after I went to the bathroom though. So, but I remember I walked outside of the condo because I didn't want to wake anybody up calling the doctor to tell them I was in labor. So I walked outside the condo and I was on the phone with the lady, like trying to talk with in between contractions, and there were people walking up and down hooting and hollering. So this lady's probably like, this girl's like at a club trying to call. Because after football games, we had won and it was against Florida. And so it was
if you've ever been in a college town after a football game, everybody's, Roll Tide!
So that was going on in the background of my call to the nurse. I don't think I've ever even told you
I remember you telling me that.
Did I? So at this point, I went and told Colin. I was like, hey, wake up. The nurse says that we need to come in. And he was like, what? And I said, yes, I think they think that I'm in labor. And he goes, where are we going to go? I was like, to the hospital. He said, can't we just go somewhere in Tuscaloosa?
Y'all got to remember, this is about an hour and five minutes.
Tuscaloosa is about an hour away from our hospital in Birmingham. And so I was like, well, my contractions are like 3 to 5 minutes apart. Look, there was one that was 18. I didn't have one for 18 minutes there at 2:20 a.m. So we had to pack all our stuff. Luckily, my stuff was actually packed because I thought we were going to be going home that night, which I'm glad we didn't because we wouldn't know what to do with the dogs. So we got up, got everything packed. I went in, told my parent, I was like, hey, don't panic, but I might be in labor. And I remember my mom sat up. She was having some vertigo, like where you're feeling dizzy. And I remember she was like, oh, hang on, I gotta lay back down. And so knowing my mom had very fast labor with me and my sister had fast labor with her kids. And so they were like, you need to go. And my dad was like, it's fine. I'm sure it'll be okay. Just take your time. Don't hurry. And so.
Also keep in mind, this girl was breech.
Yes. So Gaines was breech. And so we couldn't. I mean, not that I'd want to have a baby on the side of the road, but it happens, and it would have been okay, I suppose.
That would have been an awesome vlog.
But if I'd have gone to having her on the side of the road breech, she might not have made it.
Yeah, it would have been tragic.
It would have been really bad. My parents are like, just go. And I was like, well, what about the dogs? And they said, we'll bring the dogs. We'll be right behind you. And I remember saying, I was like, I'll call you when I get there. I don't want y'all waking up. It was 2:00 in the morning. I was like, I don't want y'all coming right now, and then I'm not really in labor.
Because you've always had in the back of her head, she don't want to be that girl that we get there, and then they send her home, and then it's like, ugh, why did I call? You know, that's why you waited so long before you called. Because you didn't want it to be a false alarm.
Especially in Tuscaloosa, like coming from an hour away. I was like, I really don't want it to be a false alarm. Like, that's just, I don't want to be that girl that's like, I'm in labor, and then I'm not. So we left Tuscaloosa about 2:15 a.m., I think. And on the way there, my contractions were about 3 minutes, 4 minutes.
Then, and that's where the birth vlog picks up, is when we're leaving, yes, walking out of the condo to get in the car.
So if you haven't seen that, go watch that.
Go check that out.
But on the way, I was timing my contractions. This contraction app called Full Term, by the way, is a really great app. You just push start, stop, and it keeps track of everything for you. And I remember being in labor, or having contractions and thinking, I have no idea how people actually write this stuff down and watch a second hand, because I couldn't do that. You just hit start and stop. But so on the way there, they were like 3 to 4 minutes. Then around 2:40, so we'd been gone for about 20 minutes at this point, and they started getting like 2.5 to 3 minutes apart.
Now,
like,
she's in full gorilla mode.
I was like freaking out. Yes. Stop.
She was making those like weird, deep, like, ooh. And in our birthing class, we're making fun of those videos that they show you. I'm like, if you ever make these noises, I'm gonna laugh my butt off.
And I said the same thing. I was like, oh my gosh.
But they said they help because, like, if you use high pitched voices, you're cutting off oxygen. But she was just like, in full, like, oh.
It was a little louder than that.
Yeah,
though.
It was like, and you would just like freaking do the invisible seatbelt, and you're like, oh.
Here's some that are like 2 minutes and 43 seconds, 2 minutes and 3 seconds, 2 minutes and 7 seconds. Like, they were really close together. And I was just in between, I was texting my sister and telling her the updates, because I had texted her and she was like, oh my gosh, where are you? How far are you now? How far are you now? Like, from
and I was flying.
There.
Like, I didn't care if we got pulled over. I had in my mind, I was like, I'm either going to pull over and tell him, look, just look. Would you just look at it? I'm not getting a ticket. We're going to the hospital. Or I was just going to keep going with the lights on behind me and, like, have the whole city follow me.
Which we didn't think about this until somebody told us afterwards. But if this does happen to you and they try to pull you over, you can call 911 and say, hey, I'm getting pulled over, but my wife is in labor. If you will let the police officer know, then they'll just follow you
to the
hospital.
They'll probably, like, pull up in front of you and escort you.
Yes. So that would have been a better decision. But at that point, I was like, I don't care.
I think in the birth vlog, I showed that we were going, like, 84. But I was up there. I was getting up into the 90s, like,
which, yeah, I know,
with every contraction, my foot got heavier. I was like, oh my gosh. But it was unsafe, but it was also unsafe.
Yeah, for
like
her to be
born. If you went into labor, I mean, yeah, if you water broke, woo!
Kill. I just remember they got so close together that, like, the weirdest thing about labor to me was that once the contraction was over, there was, like, no remaining pain. And so I was like, okay, let me text my sister back and tell her how she is. And then they got so close together that I was like, no, please don't be another one. Please don't feel it. And I could feel it coming. And then it would just go to full one. I was like, yep, here it comes. Hang on. Oh! And then once it was over, like, I could function and talk. But for, like, a minute, you know, it wasn't for very long. So we're flying down the road. I'm texting my sister. I finally see the hospital. Like, it took us an hour, I think, probably 50, 55 minutes to an hour to get there. I see the hospital. I'm like, okay, at least we're close to the hospital. We're there. And if you watch the birth vlog, all the parking for women in labor spots were full. And so I was like, you got to just find a parking place. I don't care. Just pull up. Just park somewhere. So we got out.
I know. And everybody was like, why didn't you just throw her? A lot of y'all were like, why didn't you go to the emergency room? But our doctor in the hospital said, if you ever go into labor, don't go to the emergency room. Go to the labor and delivery.
Yeah, which was the best thing, because they took me right back, knew what was going on, and
had it
everything.
All record. Yeah, everything was there.
It was all good.
And also, looking back, if you had gone into labor earlier in the day.
Yes.
I don't know if y'all have ever been to a football game wherein there's only, like, really basically one way out. The traffic is horrible. That's why we like to hang out after the games and kind of take our time to let traffic die down. But if we'd have gone into, if you'd gone into labor while we were in traffic, we wouldn't have made it.
No, that would have been really bad. So it would have been, yeah. Well, and I remember even when we left, it was 2:00 in the morning. There's a bunch of drunk college kids. There was somebody coming the wrong way down a one-way street.
I was like, is this a Twilight Zone?
Yes.
Like, and I was still half asleep. I was like, what's going on? People are coming at me on a one-way street.
And I was like, just get us out of this town where there's a bunch of drunk people. We do not need to get in a wreck right now. That was stressful too.
Yeah.
So we get to the hospital. We found a parking spot. And when we went to get out of the car, I was like, oh my gosh, I can't walk. Like, I cannot walk right now. You're going to have to hang on. So I finally, like, hobbled in there. The security guy that lets you into the
hospital. And a lot of people were like, why didn't you get a wheelchair? But you couldn't sit down. You were like, I can't sit down.
No, they tried to give me a wheelchair once I got upstairs.
Like, no,
and
I just need to go.
It was just an interesting, I mean, obviously.
The security guard. Typically, and I found out this days later, like, every time I left the hospital to go get food, he would, like, body scan me to make sure I wasn't bringing in a gun or any metal objects or anything like that. But he saw us walking up. He had already gone over, pushed the elevator. He opened the door. He said, third floor, go ahead.
And
didn't ask
didn't
any
say
questions.
Anything. I mean, it was obvious that we were having a baby right then.
Yeah.
And I remember when we pulled up.
I still didn't think when we were pulling up, I was like, I know you're in contract. I don't know if you're going to have a baby, though.
Yeah.
I didn't think it was going to happen.
You just think that I have a very low pain tolerance, and I was just being a wuss, probably.
It was gas the whole time.
I just remember when I pulled up to the hospital, I'd been texting my sister, like, I'm not sure, you know, and I remember texting her and saying, no, this is going to be her birthday. Like, I know she's going to come today. And so we got on the elevator, went upstairs. You have to, like, buzz in to the little labor and delivery area.
And you're supposed to tell them why you're there.
And there's a camera.
What your name is.
And I buzzed the thing, and I was like, I guess I had just the look on my face. They're like, come on back.
And they didn't even ask.
And as soon as we walked in those doors and I saw the nurse's station and, like, where I was supposed to go sign in, I just,
broke
into tears. I was like, oh, my gosh, we made it, and please help me. So we walked up, and they were like, I'm going to need you to sign in here. And
you
write your.
That.
I was like, I can't.
So then
it.
They give it to me, and I'm freaking out. Now I'm like, what? And so they like.
They said, what's her?
What's her birthday? I was like, I don't even know what her birthday is right now. I put it backwards, and they had to call back again.
Oh yeah,
and
you did.
And they were like, wait, is her birthday? And
you put 82.
Yeah,
83.
Or no, I put something else. Like I put you like you're 12, I think. I don't know.
Well, and then they asked for my social security number, and they were like, well, what's your social security number? I was like. So I had to wait till the contraction was over, give them my social security number. But you got me signed in. They were like, here, sit down in this wheelchair. And I tried, and I was like, oh, nope, that's not gonna happen. I had to stand, like, leaning over the desk was the only thing that made it feel better. And so then they took me back to a room, and I felt terrible, because the labor,
it was
like,
early in the morning.
You do labor and you deliver in the same area where people that have already had babies are. Like, it's all one area. So there were people with, like, sleeping babies and stuff, and I'm screaming, and I was like, I'm so sorry, but I cannot help it right now.
Yeah. Like, they were like, can you take your pants off? I've never seen her take her pants off that quick.
Yeah, when we got into the room, the, like, lady said, let
no
me
shame.
Check you, take your pants off. And I just was like, help.
There were panties flying everywhere. I was like, dang, girl.
I didn't care. And I mean, I was like, they're going to see it all anyways. Just take them off. So we got there at 3:10 was when I texted my sister and I said, okay, we're here. And yes, so 3:10 we got there. This is all happening. They checked me and the nurse is like, I said, or she kind of didn't say anything. And I was like, so am I dilated? And she goes, I didn't really want to push around too much because I didn't want to break the water. And that's really, yeah. So at that point I was like,
I think
like,
it was like bulging.
Yes. So it was, you know, it was ready. And so then another nurse came in and said something about, well, since you're complete, and Cullen goes, oh, she's 10 centimeters.
That's when it all hit.
And the nurse goes, oh, you didn't know already?
Yeah, I was like, oh gosh, we're having a baby.
Yeah, and
it finally hit me.
And I was supposed to have a C-section because she was breached. So we were freaking out.
Yes.
Like, crap, I'm 10 centimeters, and if my water were to break right now, that would not be good. And so they had to call the doctor.
Because a foot would have slipped out.
Yeah, and that can block the cord.
Yeah. You know, clamp the cord, and then that would have been bad.
Yeah, it could have just all been bad. So obviously it's the middle of the night, so the doctor on call isn't even at the hospital. They had to call her from home. So I was like, oh my gosh, get her here, give me some drugs, please somebody help me. And so they had to get an IV in. In between contractions, I was signing papers. They were like, we have to have your consent to do all this. And I was like,
can I sign it for her? And I just signed it for her.
No, you can't. You couldn't. You signed a couple things.
I signed a couple things.
But I think there was one I had to sign myself.
I think the main one, yeah.
And so they were like, okay, tell me when it's almost over. And so I was like, okay, it's over. Sign, hurry.
And she's got small veins, and like they always have trouble picking her when they put an IV in. I was like, this is going to be a nightmare, because she was like in between contractions, and the girl came over and she was like tapping it, trying to get a vein to pop out.
Like, you're going to have to hurry.
And I was like, oh my God. She did really good though.
It got right in, and so I had my IV, which was, I think at that point it was just fluids. Like, I wasn't getting any pain medicine or anything at that point.
Yeah.
So then, finally, I guess it seemed like forever, but it was probably, 10 minutes? The doctor made it there. Or probably longer than 10 minutes.
And they had already given 15. Me my scrubs and all that to wear.
Yes. The doctor came in, and she was like, okay, I'm going to need you to keep your legs together. And, like, she was serious. Like, no joke. Like, do not do anything that's going to make anything happen. So they were getting everything prepped. They gave you, threw you your scrubs, like, here.
I was like, wait, I don't even know how to put this on, because it, like, ties around your ears and stuff.
Oh, yeah.
And I was like, oh my gosh, what's going on? This is really happening. Oh, crap. They told me about this in the birth class, but I didn't really think we were going to have to do this.
Well, because it was so fast. Like, we got there and expected to, like, oh, I'm going to be in labor for a while. And in between, we're texting people, like, my parents going, oh, we're really going to have a baby right now, so I hope y'all got the dogs and everything's okay. Then they rolled me over into the operating room.
Yes.
And I remember Colin was walking with me, or with us, like, with the bed, and they were like, okay, you can't come anymore. Like, you can't go with us. And
it was
all like,
sterile for them.
What? And they said, well, you'll be able to come, but we had to, like, get it all situated. And so I was like, I love you. Bye. And so you had to sit out there by yourself. I had to go in there having contractions. Like, the doctor walked up next to me right when a contraction started, and I just, like, grabbed her. And I was like, I'm sorry. I just need...
And they had to put the epidural in. Or no, it wasn't an epidural. It was spinal block.
Or whatever it's
something
called.
Something to numb her legs.
Yes. So the anesthesiologist came in and was like, we're going to have to try our best to get this in, because if it doesn't get in on the first time, we're going to have to knock you out, like, completely asleep. Like, I would have missed the birth
and
of my
child.
And how
bad would that have been? Like,
and I know it happens. I'm sure some of y'all watching may have had this experience that happens. But I was just like, please just get it in. And so he was like, just let me know right when your contraction's about to end, and we'll sit you up and try to get it in before the next contraction comes. Because there's no way I could have done it during a contraction, because I was full out, like, had to move during the contractions. So the contraction started in. I was like, okay, it's ending. It still hurts, but they helped me swing my legs around. And he was like, all right, just be still. And so he had to get my back all prepared and stick the little thing on there. And at that point, I was like, crap, I feel another contraction coming. And he was like, just hold as still as you can. So I had to hold super still. And it was starting, I was starting to have a contraction, but I was like, dear God, please just keep me still, because I just need this thing to go in. And he got it in, like, immediately. He was amazing. And
the whole time I'm outside, I can hear her through the closed doors screaming. And then it was just, it was kind of weird walking to the emergency, or walking to the operation room, hearing you scream in full pain, and then I walk in and you're like, hey, what's up, baby? And I'm like, well, dang.
Yeah, so what were your thoughts when you were out there? What else?
Y'all saw, if y'all were following me on Twitter, y'all saw a picture, and I just was like, deer in headlights. Like, I was really nervous, because I didn't, like I said, right when they said she was full term, I was like, oh my God,
fully dilated.
I was like, we're having a baby.
Yeah.
We're about to have, this is like the last few seconds before there's another person in our little hands.
Yeah, it so was crazy. It was just, like, on the way down there, I was like, really, are we really going to have a baby today? Like, this is crazy. It's September. She was supposed to wait till October. So they got the spinal thing in, and, you know, slowly my legs started getting numb and the contraction started going away. And I was like, oh my gosh, this is the best thing ever. I don't feel any more pain. Thank you for the pain help. And then enter the birth vlog, where you can see her being born. You know, they cut me open. It was a
they were
C-section.
Real nice about letting me vlog in there and everything.
Yeah.
And they didn't ask any questions. I was just like, I even handed the guy, I said, can you video this? Because I wanted to, like, sit there and hold her, and you couldn't do anything. The C-section went perfect.
Everybody was really nice too. The guy that kept talking
really nice
to me, was he wasn't the anesthesiologist, was he?
He was keeping track of something, and, like, anytime you needed more, he would, like, and he would tell you, okay, you're about to get something to help with nausea, because you said
and he was
nausea.
Like, you're gonna feel a little bit of pulling and tugging, and he would, like, touch my shoulders. He was just very
like
comforting, and
kept her informed about what was going on behind the curtain,
because I couldn't see anything. I mean, there's a curtain, like, right here in my face, and he was telling me everything.
And then he was like, hey, smell this, and it was a little alcohol.
Oh yeah, why did I have to smell
because
that?
You were getting nauseous, and he said it'll help with the nausea.
Oh yeah, and I had oxygen in my nose and all that. And then, as you saw in the birth vlog, all the emotions of, like, when she came out, she wasn't crying at first. Like, it was probably, what, a second and a half?
It was a good little while. I mean, I was even like, But I knew that, you know, from seeing others, it takes a minute.
Well, and they hadn't, like, sucked her mouth out and all that stuff yet. So I was like, why isn't she crying? And then
it was long enough for you to ask.
Yeah.
Like,
why isn't she crying? Because they said, oh, she's here. And Colin was like, oh, she's so little and cute. And this is all in the birth vlog. You can see it. And then asked why she wasn't crying. And then she started crying. And I just broke down in tears. It's going to make me cry again thinking about it. And it was just, like, the most amazing, incredible experience. Like, it was when I was texting people. Because I had my list of who I needed to text to tell them we had the baby. But I'd... Excuse you.
Get that gas out, girl. She just got gas.
I had planned on texting people like, hey, we're in the hospital. We're probably going to have her today at some point. I'm in labor. But at this point, I was like, dang, she's here. What am I supposed to do? Like, we didn't have time to text anybody.
I texted
my
mom three times, and she never wrote back. And I was like, we're at the hospital, about to have a baby. She's here. Mom wrote back and said, wait, what? Like, an hour later, because she'd woken up because she heard her phone.
Well, and we could have, I mean, you could have called her, but it was one of those things where she's on the way. We didn't think, honestly, that she was going to be here that quick. And then she was, and so we were like, well, crap, she's here, by the way. But I was texting people, and I was saying it was, like, the most intense and painful experience, but the most incredible, amazing, like, wonderful experience
she
of my life.
She basically did, you went into labor, full labor, 10 centimeters, and never had the baby naturally, because you couldn't, because she was breached.
The only thing I didn't do was push.
The only thing she did not do was push.
I went through all of labor to 10
centimeters. And the C-section, I don't think, was that, for those of y'all that might wonder. I mean, it wasn't that bad, was it, in the recovery?
And no. It wasn't as bad as I expected. I mean, it's surgery, and maybe that was my perspective is I've had surgery before, like I had my gallbladder out and stuff like that. So I knew that it wasn't like I was just going to be jumping up, running around, which I guess I kind of was.
You were the next day.
No, I was that same day.
Same day, I remember.
When Heather and Drew came to visit us. I'd gotten up and gotten dressed and changed clothes and all that stuff. So she was born. They wheeled us back to our room. Cullen's mom hurried and got dressed and came. My parents had to take the dogs back to their house. And then come.
So we got to the hospital at 3:10. She was born at 4:03.
Yes.
That quick.
So interestingly, that was 53 minutes. And when I was born, my mom got to the hospital at 4 a.m. and I was born at 4:53. But she had me naturally. She was already fully dilated.
Same
also.
Time.
But she was also 53 minutes before I was born.
That's
so
crazy.
Which if I had delivered her naturally, like she would have been here before then. She would have been here probably by like 3:30.
And you wouldn't have had any pain medicine.
No, I would not have gotten an epidural. I wouldn't have had any of that. Somebody asked me, like, so next time you have a baby, are you gonna go natural? Because I mean, you obviously could have done it. And I could have, but it wouldn't have been pleasant. Like, I would like to have experienced the whole labor process not being in excruciating pain, just to kind of enjoy it and think about what's going on. I don't know. Maybe it was best we didn't have time to think about what was going on. I don't know. But anyway, so we will see what happens next time. But so we got back to the room. Everything was good. The C-section went fine. No complications. Sweet little baby was here. And
just with her being so small, they had to regulate her temperature and make sure everything was good and her hips. And we all know about all that stuff. But
so I was able to hold her. I wasn't able to hold her skin to skin like immediately. They tried it. But it wasn't regulating her temperature enough, so they had to put her in the little, just a little thing with a warmer over it. It wasn't like an incubator or anything, just a little warming station. How long did it take for my feeling to come back in my legs? Like maybe an hour or so?
Mm-hmm.
And then a couple hours after that, the nurses came in, let me get up and go to the bathroom, and then the rest is history.
That's
I guess
how
that's
you
all
baby.
You include in your birth story. I don't know if there's anything else.
Then here's the little princess.
And then this is what you get for going through all that craziness.
Yeah.
So it was an eventful period of time there from the football game to the hospital. I mean, it was crazy. It just happened so fast. And
it did. And she weighed 5 pounds, 8 ounces when she was born. And she was 18 inches long. So she was a little tiny peanut. Oh, Daddy.
Dinosaur
don't
noises.
Mess with me. I was trying to sleep and y'all just woke me up to be in this video.
And she smells so good. Mm.
It was all worth it, and I would do it all again in a minute. Like it was really just an amazing experience. Like I would have never planned to go through it like I did and have all the pain and get to 10 centimeters with no medication. But looking back on it, I'm kind of glad it happened that way just because I don't know. It just was part of it. Mm-hmm. And I like having that experience for this little baby.
So y'all leave a comment below letting us know your birth story. What kind of crazy, fun, exciting adventures did you go on when you had your little baby, if any?
And also something we didn't say is that, because everybody kept asking me, they're like, did you know you were going to go early and have her early? And I really didn't, but I knew with the high blood pressure there was a chance. But this wasn't because of my high blood pressure that she came early. My mom and my sister both had babies early. My mom had my sister 2 weeks early. My sister had all her kids 2 to 4 weeks early. So Gaines just falls right in that range of 2 to 4 weeks early also. So I just kind of anticipate that I will be one to have babies a little bit early, like the women in my family, which I'm totally fine with that. As long as she's healthy and happy and fine, I don't mind her being here a little bit early.
Yeah,
she would have only been 6 days old by now if she had been born.
That's just crazy. I was just telling Katie this morning, she's going to be a month old soon. Like, that's a long time. We're just very blessed and thankful that she got here safe and sound. And
yes, so thankful.
Appreciate all of the love and support on that birth vlog. That was a fun vlog to edit. It was an emotional vlog.
And then Colin edited that vlog the day she was born and had it posted that night after we'd been up all night.
I was just running on adrenaline and happiness. It was just amazing. So
amazing.
Anyway, amazing. So anyway, guys, if y'all haven't already, subscribe to our channel. We put out daily vlogs every day, and that'll do it for this little segment of www.com. www.putmeintolabor.com.
Thank y'all for listening to all the details. Sorry it was kind of long, but I want to remember every little detail for myself for when I go back and watch this, or for when Gaines goes back and watches it when she's grown up.
Yeah! That's today's daily vlog. We'll be back to regular daily vlogs tomorrow.
Yay.
We will see what OTFS.
Catch you on the flip side.
Bye! You know that when you're ready, that you're the one for
for me. Can't I still be leading? Yeah, yeah. We're taking it slow, we'll see where it goes. I already know if you're asking that you're the one for me. You're the one for me. Yeah, you're the one for me. You're the one for me, babe. Almost.